Welcome back to the Jason in the House podcast. I'm Jason Chaffetz. Appreciate you joining us today. We're gonna phone a friend, Brandon Judd, who is the president of the National Border Patrol Council. You've probably seen him on Fox News, like 24 years in the Border Patrol. He's going to talk to us a little bit about what's really going on the border. I've interacted with him quite a bit along the way, learned a ton from him, but we're going to give him a phone call. We're going to talk a little bit about what's going on in the news, and then, of course, we're going to highlight the stupid because, you know, there's always somebody doing something stupid somewhere. But let's start with a little bit about what's going on in the news. You've probably heard by now, it's clearly out there that Joe Manchin, the Democratic senator from West Virginia, has said that there's no way, despite all of his best efforts, that he can support the Build Back Better plan that was coming out of the White House. Now, what I think is noteworthy here, and again, you've probably seen this and heard this, but the Democrats are just going nuts about this, trying to blame him for this, that, and the other. But I got to tell you, I think the Democrats way overplayed their hand. They're using this tool called reconciliation. And as a quick review, each year when you pass a budget, you can pass, they go through this process called reconciliation. They reconcile what passes in the House with what passes in the Senate. And in order to get to that, because those that write the rules in the Senate realize that you're going to have to just get a simple majority to get that passed. You don't have to go through the filibuster. You don't have to get to that 60 vote cloture vote in order to get to, hey, should we consider the bill? Normally a bill has to get to 60 votes on whether or not to proceed, and then they vote on it, and then it needs a simple majority. This bypasses all that. So you just need 50 plus one. Well, they're all blaming Joe Manchin. You know, but Joe Manchin's been very clear since the very beginning. I think the Democrats are trying to blame everything on Joe Manchin. Joe Manchin, who has been very clear on what he wants and what he believes is acceptable. I think the Democrats overplayed their hand because they thought that they had a mandate. You heard, and we probably should have listened to Bernie Sanders, Senator Bernie Sanders from Vermont. Before Joe Biden was elected, he said that Joe Biden, if elected, would be the most progressive, the most liberal president in the history of the United States. And you know what? He's right. He's pretty much turned out to be that. He's taken this progressive New Green Deal thing to the to the far left, the crazy world that I don't think anybody recognized. Remember, the Democrats only have control of the Senate in part because of losing two Senate seats that Republicans did in Georgia, where for each of those votes, I believe you had more than 100,000 people not show up. People that voted for Donald Trump, but when it came to do a runoff, didn't show up and vote in that election. Nevertheless, the Democrats won, but they've hardly had a mandate. They didn't have the massive numbers that some of these previous presidents had in the House and the Senate. So what you ultimately have is actually a majority of senators voting no on Build Back Better. That's why they can't proceed. That's why they literally never had in the Senate, never got to a point where they had text, nor did they ever get to a point where they passed what's called the Byrd rule or the Byrd bath. Senator Byrd was the one that helped craft these rules. I think he was the longest serving senator in the history of the country from West Virginia. And what he did is he set up the rules and basically said, if you're going to do reconciliation, you can do no legislating. You can pass a bill that has to deal with taxes and revenue and expenditures, but you can't do what the Democrats tried to do, for instance, on immigration and legislate through that process. That requires a separate bill. So again, Democrats never had the text of the bill. They never had the mandate that they said they did. They overextended and tried to put everything under the sun in the largest bill in the history of the United States of America, something that the Congressional Budget Office said extended out over a 10-year period would cost $5 trillion. And there was just no way that they could do that. And they kind of forgot something along the way, and that is they told the American people, guess what? This isn't going to cost anything. It's going to be free. Never was going to be free. They kept telling the American people there was a lie. Hey, guess what? It won't cost you anything. Yeah, right. Well, it does cost something. And the CBO, the Congressional Budget Office, said it would cost $5 trillion. Remember, spend $1 million a day every day. It would take you almost 3,000 years to get to $1 trillion. This thing was going to cost $5 trillion on top of the tens of trillions of dollars of debt that we already have. All right, enough on that. I want to go to this next thing because this really does have to do with Brandon Judd and the Border Patrol and what's going on. But over at FoxNews.com, I was reading this story just a couple days ago. A 21-year-old man was apprehended entering the United States via Mexico through Yuma, Arizona. The Border Patrol is broken up into sectors. This is the Yuma sector. And the chief patrol agent, Chris T. Clem, said that this suspect, he appeared to be wearing a jacket emblazoned with an American flag patch and another that stated Central Oneida County Volunteer. What a facade, right? Putting on, oh yeah, let's wear a jacket with an American flag. Ends up that he was a Yemeni. He was from Yemen. That he was a potential terrorist, according to the Border Patrol, and that he was a Yemeni subject of interest. He's a potential terrorist coming across the border. Now, remember, the Border Patrol is putting out record numbers under the Biden administration, the Obama extension, if you will. The Obama-Biden years were similar, but not nearly as bad as what's going on with Joe Biden and Kamala Harris. That border is wide open, and by the hundreds of thousands, people are getting away, going across the border unimpeded. They just happen to capture this one, and it makes you wonder what other type of suspects are getting through. These are not just necessarily innocent people. Oh, I'm just trying to better my life. No, not necessarily. People have figured out how wide open that border is, and it is disgusting, it is sickening, and our country is going to pay a heavy, heavy price in a lot of different ways moving forward. All right, time to bring on the stupid, because you know what? There's always somebody doing something stupid somewhere. All right, I got two this week. Not only do we have Senator Elizabeth Warren, but we have Representative Ocasio-Cortez, who's a regular. She, of course, was in line on MSNBC blaming Joe Manchin. And here's what she said. This is a quote. So the idea that Joe Manchin says he can't explain this back home to his people is a farce. I mean, it's a farce in terms of plain democracy because I represent more or just as many or more people than Joe Manchin does. Perhaps more. No, you really don't. You know, as a member of Congress, you represent 700,000 to 800,000. West Virginia has about 1.8 million residents, so you're off by a million. It just kind of goes to the ongoing credibility questions about AOC and what she spiels out there. I know she's mad. She's frustrated. She wants everybody to be this crazy, wild liberal that she is, but they're not. And don't be out there making up lies about Joe Manchin. This is a small one on the big scale of things, but it's just illustrative of how stupid you could be by going out there and saying that she represents more people than Joe Manchin does. He's a United States Senator. She's a representative. He represents a million more than her. And those are just the facts. All right, let's get to the next one. I love this one. And you know what? Honestly, from my, I really do believe this. She has, Elizabeth Warren has been, it's been said, diagnosed with COVID. And I hope she does get better. I don't want any harm to go to anybody who contacts this virus. Set that aside for a second. You could still criticize what she says and how she says it and what she does. But Senator Elizabeth Warren was trolling Elon Musk on Twitter world, saying that he was essentially the prime example of why the tax code needs to change, that this rich person was just living off the backs of everybody else. Well, there was a reason why Elon Musk in the year that she pointed to did not pay taxes. He didn't have any revenue, didn't take a salary, didn't sell any of his assets or properties or anything else. And when you don't have an income and you don't sell anything, you don't pay any taxes. Now you're going to pay your day-to-day taxes, you know, when you're buying food and that kind of stuff. But you're not going to be paying the type of taxes that she insists.